Chicago Bridge magazine. I'm here with another important individual. I'm about to learn a lot about him. What's your name, sir?
Gary Reeves.
Man, pleasure to meet you, Mr. Gary Reeves.
Thank you, man.
Thank you so much. Man, I had the pleasure of hearing this man speak along with him.
Socialize it, you like it, or you love it. Those who love it will always win. So if it's sports, I often with young kids, I tease in the classroom and say, hey, if it's two guys that's going after the same girl, if you socialize with her, that's fine. If you like her, that's fine. But the guy that's loving is going to win. So that's up to you. So that's in anything. You know, so love always wins. Yeah. I'm from Berkeley, California. Started out as a spiritual advisor for the Golden State Warriors at the age of 19, 12 to 32. At a very young age, the light turned on for me in reference to how I wanted to start cultivating my life and understanding the importance of not only honoring my God, but also, you know, loving people, not being fearless around how you, you know, choose to move and navigate your life. First, and never put money before people, and understanding that, you know, how we treat people is how life shows up for us. And, you know, 40 years, you know, almost 40 years later, I'm still on the same narrative. Life showed up properly for me. I've had my challenges, but I've been able to attack it with the right answer.
Okay, with that being said, you have challenges that you turn to other than obviously God.
Well, I mean, to be honest with you, I take the character and the wisdom of what God has shared with me and how I pay attention. And really the answers are there. I mean, unfortunately, but I've just always been comfortable in my own skin and my own relationship with God and knowing that He has the answers. If we slow down and pay attention.
Yeah. Is there a website involved with
what I do? Yeah, so, I mean, I have a show, I'm a TV film producer, I have a show on NBC called Give, in Blair Underwood. Prior to that, I've done a number of other TV shows. I've been involved with a number of non-celebrities. So, probably that's the most recent project. I just like people to show up because they're supposed to, and I move that
way. You've done a lot of prominent things in your life, and, you know, you earlier, you know, about this being NBA All-Star Weekend, you know, Chicago 2020,
right.
Perfect Vision.
Right.
You know, we mentioned someone who made a big name in Chicago, being Michael Jordan.
Right.
And I know you've done some business. Right. Talk about business how you go, right?
Yeah, so Michael actually gave me the rights to Michael Jordan's playground, which was a story about him getting cut in the 10th grade. At the time, no one knew that story and that narrative. And as I was a spiritual advisor for the Warriors, I had a soft relationship with Mike. And I really approached him about how important that narrative is for all people, you know, in reference to we all have challenges. We all have people evaluating, you know, our gift. And sometimes that evaluation isn't accurate. So Michael got cut in the 10th grade. If he would have given up then, we wouldn't know Michael as we know him today. And so the message in that is, don't let one person's opinion of your ability kill your dream and your passion. And so I ended up producing that. That was my first project. It ended up doing well. It ended up with prayer for me in film and television, what I call social good content, which is content that inspires our community. And that, you know, pretty much set up my career path. In reference to TV, media, and then having my passion to feel in wanting to serve community. I probably would end up being a minister, maybe, if I didn't do this. But really it's about loving people, and that's not all. You know, it's not a career. It's just something that innately what we should have on our sleeve every day we wake up is how do we love people? You know, how do we make ourselves better? You know, how do we self-correct? So that's kind of really, I have no shame that women's leadership, as men, we wouldn't be here without women. I mean, it's not hard narrative. It's just slowing down and really understanding that reality. So I'm fearless around.
I wouldn't be for
thank you.
You know, being the person you are, you know, doing for others, you know, having a heart for others, that's love. Right. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Definitely
God. Right. Yeah.
How can people reach out if they want to support us?
You know, via email, G purpose of that actually was my, as I was speaking earlier about my son with brain surgery, that was a severe injury. So that spelled backwards is severe. So that's where that came from. The double E backwards in our logo is they both, my kids went to Mandarin school at a young age because they felt they didn't get Spanish and French in public school. Mandarin they can't get. So they need to also know Pacific Rim and the Asian in the network as well because of the influence. How they're supplying the U.S. products and the tariffs and all that. So I never wanted my kids to be at a disadvantage. So it's no language that you can't speak. The only reason why you shouldn't be there when you walk into any room. So we can't lose our faith in God. Can't lose our faith in truly believe in our heart, no matter what the distractions are, no matter what the naysayers are. I think those are just the challenges to see if we can break them.
I really appreciate your time.
And thank you for
your endeavors.
Yeah, thank you. You too, man. And
your heart.
Hey, we got to confirm each other and support each other when we can. I think we wake up with a consciousness around that. We can transform a lot of turbulence that's in our community.
Absolutely. He said it. I said it. Peace out. Blessings. All day.
Thank you.